Hello, everybody. Nice to meet you. Whoops. Thank you for inviting me here today. And thank you to Sekudas and Boligselskaberne Landsforening for organizing this important event. The European economies are under pressure. In such time, it's easy to let the political perspective slide from long-term to short-term initiatives. It is, however, absolutely important that we keep the focus on our principal targets. How do we, now and in the future, maintain a sufficient supply of sustainable housing, both in terms of social, economic, and environmental sustainability? Those the topic of today's agenda. Responsible housing as a driver of sustainable growth is very well chosen. It poses very important questions, and the answer will have consequences far behind here and now. It is, of course, very easy to raise the questions. I think it's much harder to answer it. So it is in politics also. Nevertheless, we have to insist on a persistent development of our housing concept. Or to put it in a very simple way, we must keep on insisting that it is possible to improve the existing housing stock as well as the standards of new constructions in order to improve living conditions of the environment and the economy. I must admit that it's very easy to forget that kind of thinking in the daily routines, where we now had to deal with a never-ending flow of short-term challenges. Nevertheless, as a minister of the housing sector, I must insist of that implementations of a long-term politics are vital if we want to maintain a well-functioning housing market that effectually contributes to the well-being of all citizens through the provision of a good, healthy, and affordable housing. That is the main objectives in the housing politics. In pursuing these objectives, however, it's possible to serve and the other vital purposes, growth in general, employment, and job creations. Especially, I have taken a great interest in securing that young people get a chance to take and fulfill education in the construction sector. Most European countries have expectations that the problem of the youngest out of the job or the lack of job training opportunities. Most politicians probably aim of contributing the economic growth and the creation of sustained and positive development of our societies, but few have in the reality the right opportunities to do so. In that respect, ladies and gentlemen, I am very privileged. Building and renovation in the social housing sector in Denmark offers great opportunities for supporting growth. As you probably already know, we have more than 500,000 dwellings in social housing. The great majority of these were built in the years from the 1960s to the 1990s. In general, social housing is well maintained, but it is evident that 30 or 50 year old buildings need upgrading. Not only in relation to present household size, but also in relation to technical installations and energy consumptions. And of course, we still have to build new homes and better homes for the elderly. I can tell you in Denmark, it's more actual for some of us. We are talking of investments of billions of Danish kroners today and in the years to come. In a Danish context, that is an immense challenge but also the chance to invest in the future for sustainable growth. Personality, I believe that it is the right way. This is the way forward. Responsibilities, housing, politics are now are not in conflict with sustainable growth. It is possible to combine the necessary improvements of the social housing stocks with effort to reduce the energy consumptions to improve the employment. However, building for the future is not a walk in the park, as we say. It is, in fact, a complicated task to meet unknown demands and wishes at reasonable cost. So we need some guidance here. This is the reason why I have arranged an open competition about sustainable housing, social housing, with the competitions we want to the challenge. That's the architects, the building owners, everybody dealing with social housing. So come on, show us the futures here. Use sustainability as far as you can possibly imagine. Show us how the flexibility in the future social housing can be present. Show us how to combine community spirit with a room of privacies. There is only one precondition. It must be possible to build the two winding projects within the existing frames of the Social Housing and Social Housing Act and the economic limits set by the Act. I am confident that the challenge will be met, and I am really looking forward to seeing the winning projects in June next year. We cannot go on building for the type of households that do not exist any longer. In fact, we cannot look back to identify the future housing needs. This is only one answer, but we had to build as flexible as possible to dwelling and maybe buildings are easily adjustable to the needs of the future. What we in the long term needs is sustainable models for social housing, a model for that provides good, flexible and modern housing for the most of the populations. Likewise, we had to realize that the climate change can only be met by new thinking in the building constructions. The full consequences of this are yet to be seen. The same could be said about the energy consumptions in our housing sectors. In a way, you could say that the future challenges already are here, and they need to be handled now. Just like in the old Elvis song, a little less conversations, a little more action, please. That is a way of conference. That is why a conference like a forum like this one, are so very important. And you all get a chance to exchange experience and ideas and hopefully go home with meet the daily challenges with fresh eyes. I hope you will have a pleasant stay here in Denmark. I'm sorry for the weather, but I thank you for your attention. Thank you.
Let me just thank you, Carsten, for coming here and to put challenge on the housing associations in Denmark in this constructive way. Many countries are struggling with other challenges from the government, with the scrutiny of the budget, problems with long-time financing. So coming to a country that the government is behind this, the housing association, then and also give them challenges to show what's the best for the future, that's something that we would really like to hear. And I know that Paula Bent have a good relation with the discussion climate with you. So thank you for taking your time, and we will follow the challenge.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.